Hi everyone, my name is Harpreet Singh and I'm a customer engineer for Azure Identity with Microsoft Customer Experience team. Today we are going to review basics about filter for devices condition within conditional access policies. Azure AD conditional access policy is at the heart of identity driven control plane, and including attribute based device filtering options in these policies can add additional layer of security. These options provide administrators an ability to introduce a granular approach to include or exclude specific devices registered in their Azure AD tenant. The scenario which we would be going through is to limit access for Office applications and Azure AD management portal only on devices which are Azure AD joined or hybrid Azure AD joined. In short, we are trying to block BYOD or personal devices from accessing Office or Azure management portals. Now let's move to Azure AD portal to create this policy and test it using WhatIf tool. Within Azure AD portal, we will browse to conditional access blade and click on new policy button. We will give this policy a easily readable name which defines what exactly this policy does. In the user scope section, we will include all users and exclude global administrator role to avoid a tenant lockout scenario. For cloud apps, under include section, we'll click on select tabs, search for Office 365 and Azure management and select those applications. Under conditions, we will be configuring device platforms as well as filter for devices condition. Under device platforms, we will toggle the configure button to yes and click on include any device to make sure that all the device platforms are targeted by this policy. For filter for devices condition, we will again toggle the configure button to yes and select exclude filtered devices from the policy. We will now start creating the rule that is required to exclude Azure AD join or hybrid Azure AD join device using trust type property. In the rule builder, we will select the property as trust type. We'll choose the operator as equal and select the value as Azure AD join. In the logical operation, we will select OR and include again trust type equals hybrid Azure AD join. If you want to be very specific and add a particular device to exclusion list, you can use device ID property and specify the device ID that you want to exclude. Please make note that the rule builder has a character limit of 3072 characters. So please avoid adding too many individual device IDs as it can result in the error as showcased on the screen. The final step of policy creation is to click on block access button under the grant control section. This will make sure that access to Office and Azure management portals are blocked from personal or BYOD devices. Now that everything is configured, you can toggle the enable policy option to on and click on create button. We will now use WhatIf tool to simulate a sign-in and examine the policy behavior. Under conditional access blade, click on WhatIf. Now select the user that you want to examine. Click on cloud apps and select Office 365. Select a device platform of your choice. Under filter for devices, mark the property as trust type and add the value as Azure AD register. Selecting Azure AD register would simulate a personal or a BYOD device scenario. Now, when you click WhatIf button, the policies will be evaluated against the simulated sign-in. Once the policy evaluation completes, you will see that the policy that we just created pops up with the grant control as block access, which means the policy that we created is working as expected and blocking personal or BYOD devices. Similarly, Using different device-based attributes, you can create multiple conditional access policies depending on your use case. To get a comprehensive list of device-based attributes that can be used in filter for device condition, you can follow the link highlighted on the video. I hope you liked this video and it helped you to learn more about filter for device conditions within conditional access policy. Stay tuned for part 2, wherein we will be discussing about how to troubleshoot device-based conditional access policies and sign-ins associated to the same. That's it for this video. Thank you for watching and I hope you find this useful. You can also check out the complete Azure Active Directory playlist for some amazing content.